Lately, I've been watching Angie Antitheist's ongoing video critique of Rick Warren's book, The Purpose-Driven Life, and it has raised some issues to my mind that I don't think are said often enough about the sense of purpose offered by religion. For starters, what is purpose and why is it such a big deal to many people? We all decide what goals and ambitions to pursue, so we do shape our own destinies. I'd even agree with the idea that there is a purpose greater than ourselves. We derive purpose from external sources all the time when we assist our loved ones and friends, and the impact we have on the lives of others is certainly a purpose of some significance. But the objection I raise to religious purpose is this notion of an external, cosmic, and transcendent purpose for our lives. I'll call this ultimate purpose. There is also an association of happiness and contentment with knowing one's ultimate purpose, and this I find interesting, particularly for how completely backwards it is. Why should knowing your purpose make you any happier or more content with your life? If there is such a thing as ultimate purpose, it will, by definition, have nothing to do with human desires, because it allegedly transcends opinions and wishes. So why does it always seem like religion's promise of purpose comes wrapped up with additional promises of happiness and fulfillment in life? Sure, there are martyrs and missionaries who may say happiness is not guaranteed to believers, but even to die or suffer for your faith is counted as joy according to religions like Christianity. It goes beyond a simple association, though. Believers are quick to dismiss anything they consider an unfulfilling, misguided, or temporal sense of purpose. You may say that you create your own meaning in life, or that you find inspiration in your family and friends, and the believer may tell you that this kind of purpose is only temporary and therefore not as valuable as their ultimate purpose given by God. But where does this criteria for assessing the worthiness of purpose come from? This kind of reaction is exactly what we'd expect from people who have mislabeled their subjective conception of purpose as an objective one, in order to feel safe, important, etc. If you believe in ultimate purpose that transcends opinion, then your feelings on what is purposeful enough don't really mean squat. This is the irony of Rick Warren's book. While claiming that divine transcendent purpose is real for each of us, he goes on to reject every kind of purpose that is not purposeful enough in his eyes. Unless you're living by the Bible, well, Rick Warren's interpretation of it anyway, then you're not achieving your full potential. Some atheists are fond of saying that secular morality is superior to religious morality, and I would say secular purpose is also superior to religious purpose. Understanding that purpose is relative to each person is a matter of integrity and intellectual honesty, and both these things are very worthwhile components in a healthy sense of purpose or ambition. On the other hand, exalting your sense of purpose to an immutable law of the universe, purpose which you have obtained from reading a 2,000-year-old book that did not see a purpose in flatly denouncing rape or slavery, is not quite what I would call respectable, when your sole reason for assuming this boils down to faith. Religious purpose is inferior for other reasons, too. It demands that we deny our own desires and needs and prioritize primitive dogmas above every real-world concern. Now, Warren and many others do try to claim that God doesn't want you to deny who you are, because he supposedly loves you. Yet not only does the Bible say that we must shed our former lives and put on a new life in Christ, but any proposition of salvation necessarily has to involve changing something about the one to be saved in order for them to be saved. Religion tries to have its cake and eat it too by stating that God does love us just as we are, but we were not originally created as fallen creatures, so God is trying to restore us to our former selves. This doesn't actually resolve anything, however, since it still fails to accept a person as they currently are at that moment in time. And the idea that we were once perfect and holy creations, now corrupted by sin, is nothing but another faith-based assumption. I don't believe that there is a purpose to our existence that we do not define. It seems arrogant to assume that in all of the vastness of space, we human beings are the exclusive focal point of purpose and meaning. Maybe the question, why am I here, is the wrong question. Just as it wouldn't make any sense to look at a lump of dirt and ask how does it work, it could be that ultimate purpose is an irrelevant answer to an irrelevant question. Does this mean that there is no point in carrying on with life? Of course not. I think Gandalf put it best in The Fellowship of the Ring. All we have to decide is what to do with the time that is given to us. There is always a choice in how we approach life, and regardless of religious or non-religious sentiments, some people will choose to live in persistent anger or despair. Yet there are many reasons to value our lives and appreciate whatever purpose we decide to pursue. The quality and longevity of life have improved much over the last century, and we are the lucky ones who have been born on the other side of the mountain, where survival is no longer a constant concern as it was for our distant ancestors. We may find purpose in our friends, our family, and our experiences. They have helped make us who we are, and we in turn have impacted, influenced, and inspired them, and may continue to do so. What could be a greater and more immediate sense of purpose? But the world, it is running.